Are you tired of clicking around in Ads Manager trying to filter, sort, and essentially find all of the data that you need? These three reports will save you a boatload of time measuring your Facebook ad results. Now you might be asking yourself, so Bondio, what do I do now that my ads are running? Well friend, I'm glad that you asked that because what we do is we track the heck out of your results. In this video, you'll learn how to create three custom reports inside of Ads Manager. The first is the ROI snapshot report for measuring your sales results. The second is the lead progress report for measuring your lead costs. And the third is the engagement report for measuring how engaging your Facebook ads are. And be sure to stick around to the end where I'll show you how to share these reports with your team members, bosses, or clients. The ROI snapshot report is an advertiser's best friend, and you would use this report when you're running conversion objective campaigns. This means you are trying to generate sales using the purchase conversion objective, or you're generating leads using the lead conversion objective. A simple thing to note is that you do have to have your Facebook pixel installed and tracking correctly. But don't worry, we've got you covered with a video for that, teaching you exactly how to set up your Facebook pixel if you don't have that already. Be sure to check that out in the description below. To create the ROI snapshot report, we're gonna dive in to Ads Manager. On the right-hand side here, we're gonna click the columns performance drop-down button here. Scroll down to the bottom and click customize columns. You'll see a pop-up appear here. On the right-hand side, 18 columns are automatically selected for you. Since we're creating these custom reports, we're gonna delete some of these metrics and add brand new ones to create the ROI snapshot report. Click the X and remove the following: errors, delivery, ad set name, bid strategy, budget, the last significant edit, the reach, impressions, quality ranking, engagement rate ranking, conversion rate ranking, ends, and schedule. It's almost like we just deleted all of them. But we should have 5 left as we move on to adding new ones. In the search bar, begin typing checkout and put a check mark next to total and cost. One thing to note is if there's any pre-checked selections on the right-hand side here, like mobile app checkouts initiated or website checkouts initiated, let's go ahead and deselect those for everything that they appear for. Once checkout is done, we'll go back to the search bar and begin typing in purchase. This time we'll click purchase ROAS, row under total. Then under purchases, we'll click value and cost per purchase. Quickly deselect all of the checkboxes so that we're left with 10 columns selected on the right-hand side. I like to organize this report in a way where I can understand how deep people are in our sales process, starting with the initiate checkout and moving to the purchase conversion, those successful transactions. To organize it in that manner, we simply move around these columns that we just selected. So starting at the bottom, we would move our purchase ROAS all the way down, and then our purchase conversion value would be the second to last. We'll add in our cost per purchase after that, and then the number of website purchases. After that, we're gonna end with our cost per checkouts initiated, and then checkout initiated. Then, to save this report, come on down to the bottom left-hand corner to click Save as Preset. And from there, we'll call this one the ROI snapshot. And then just click apply to go back to the regular Ads Manager screen. All right, so the ROI snapshot report is really great for getting a quick at a glance view of how profitable your ads are. And this next report, the lead progress report, is going to build on that. To create the lead progress report, where we'll understand our costs per lead and what those leads are doing in our sales funnel, all we gotta do is hop into the same place that we were before, this columns, and click customize columns. Once that pop-up appears, all we're gonna do is add some new elements. This time we're not deleting any. Same as last time, we'll head up to the search bar and type in link. Select link clicks, as well as CPC cost per link click. Go ahead and also add in the CTR, the link click through rate. Next up, you'll type in registrations or leads depending on which standard event you're using with your Facebook pixel to track your conversions. Under either registrations completed or lead, you'll click total as well as the cost. Like last time, I want to arrange these columns in a very particular view, starting with leads entering into our sales process, going towards that checkout process, and ultimately a sale. So let's rearrange them again. This time from the top. After amount spent, we're going to come down to the bottom and pull up link clicks. That'll be the next one. After link clicks, we want to understand the cost per link click, how much it cost us to acquire that link click through our Facebook advertising. Then our click through rate of those links. So our links are all grouped together as one. After, we'll do our leads or our complete registration. So let's pull those up to the top under our link clicks. And be sure if these check marks are showing to deselect them as you pull it up. Last thing that we need to do is pull that cost per registration up underneath of the registrations completed, and then confirm that the order is then checkouts initiated, cost per checkout initiated, the total number of website purchases, our purchase conversion value, and then our return on ad spend. And to save it, click Save as Preset, and we'll call this one Lead Progress. When I'm looking at my lead progress report, I'm breaking it down into a few different sections. In this top example here, we've spent almost $30,000 to generate 1,259 link clicks. Now, the cost per click that you can see in the next column is simply the total ad spend divided by the number of link clicks. After that, you'll see the click-through rate for your links here. I love looking at this metric because it tells us what percentage of people who are seeing our ads are actually clicking through. So that helps me understand if we're targeting the right audience. The higher the click-through rate, the more compatible your ad is with the audience that you're targeting. After looking at our link clicks, we're gonna come on over here and look at our leads. This is the total number of leads that you've generated from these ads. And of course, this number is going to be much smaller than the traffic that you've generated because the number of people opting in or subscribing to your email list is going to be a fraction of the total amount of traffic that you've sent there in the first place. I also love knowing how much I'm spending to acquire a new lead in my business so that I can compare that to the value, the total amount of revenue that a new lead brings to the business as well. After that, we're gonna move deeper into the sales process and look at the number of checkouts initiated. Again, this is going to be a smaller number than your total leads because people are moving deeper into that sales process. I also love knowing our cost per initiate checkout so that we can understand our metrics at each and every stage of the funnel to know exactly how much it costs to get somebody on that checkout page. And lastly, we'll move to look at the number of website purchases as well as how much it costs us to acquire that customer for our business. That's the cost per purchase. The next up is the purchase conversion value. So all of those purchases, when totaled at the end of the day, equal this amount of revenue. And moving on to the last column, the holy grail of your Facebook ad metrics, your ROAS, which shows you for every dollar that you spend on Facebook advertising, how many dollars you're earning in return. The lead progress report here has everything to do with the sales process, but the next report, the engagement report, is all about your ad specific performance. To create this report, we're gonna keep it super simple and build on the lead progress report. See how we did that? Made it easy for you. Go ahead and click customize columns. However, we're gonna axe some of the selections first. Starting with leads and everything below it, go ahead and just click X to get rid of it all. You should be left with 7 columns. Your original columns we started with, and then our link engagement columns as well. Now we're gonna go ahead and add some new selections. I like coming down here to the engagement section on the left-hand side where you can see page post. And then we'll start at the post comments. So we're not really looking at how our page overall is performing, but how the ad itself is performing. Click post comments, post engagement, post reactions, post saves, and post shares, as well as the cost per post engagement. We want to understand what we are paying to generate the engagement on our ads, not just how much we're paying per link click or per purchase, but how much we're spending on the engagement itself. After that, we're going to scroll down and select 2-second continuous video views, 10-second video views, and then all of these video watches percentages. So there's 25, 50, 75, and 100. And then we'll finish this off with the video average watch time. To save this report, click Save as Preset, and then we'll call this one Post Engagement. Click Apply, and now we're going to navigate to the ad level. For every other metric, we've been looking at the campaign level to see how our campaigns are performing overall. But now it's time to get into the nitty-gritty of how these ads are performing for each and every audience. To do that, select the ads for this campaign, and now you'll see each individual ad for each audience and how people are interacting with it. My recommendation for you with this report is to use it as a discovery tool to understand which type of content resonates with your audience. Let's say you have 0 comments on your ads. Maybe your audience isn't resonating with the way that you're sharing your message. So that could be an indicator to go back and work on your copywriting skills. On the flip side, if your audience is sharing it like crazy and it's blowing up, you might be onto something there. So I'd highly recommend to continue doing that type of ad content for your community. Now, there's no right or wrong way to use these reports, but I recommend that you start to get familiar with all the different metrics so that you can use that data to make better ad buying decisions. If you're not the only decision maker that needs to see these reports, as promised, let me show you how to share this with your team members, your bosses, or your clients. Simply click Reports and then Share Link. As you can see on the screen, this report is only available to people with access to your ad account. So be sure to share it with the people that have the appropriate permissions. Now, we just briefly touched on all the metrics. So if you want to go more in depth on the 7 most important metrics you need to know, click this video on the screen. Or check out Jen Herman's Instagram video to go deeper into Instagram analytics and insights.